Russian EVA 34 will be conducted by Fyodor Yurchikhin as EV1 in the red stripe suit, and Alexander or Sasha Misurkin will be EV2 in the blue stripe suit. Sasha will egress Pirs docking compartment 1 or DC1 first, and Fyodor will pass out the universal EVA cable carrier with a 2 MLM power cables along with a few EVA installable cable fairleads. Fyodor will also pass out the MLM Ethernet cable reel and 2 temporary connector patch panels. He will also pass out gap spanners and Vinoslivost panel number 2. Then Fyodor will egress. Sasha will take the Ethernet cable reel bundle and Vinoslivost number 2, and Fyodor will take the universal cable carrier around DC1 to Strela 1. At Strela 1's end effector, the 2 will attach the universal cable carrier to Strela 1's end effector. Sasha will translate up Strela 1 to MRM2 and temp stow his hardware on MRM2's handrail. Sasha will then make his way to Strela 1's operator post. Sasha will then manually maneuver Strela 1's boom with Fyodor and the universal cable carrier at the end effector to the FGB near the US and Russian interface. Fyodor will attach a tether from the Strela 1's boom to a FGB handrail. Fyodor will translate to Strela cradle near Strela 2 and retrieve the cradle. He will take the cradle back to Strela 1 and attach the cradle to the FGB and Strela 1 to stabilize Strela 1's boom. And will also release the tether from Strela 1 once the cradle is attached. Fyodor will then relocate a cable connector that was routed on a previous EVA. He will then install a few cable fairleads on the FGB. Sasha will install the Vinoslivost number 2 on the backside of MRM2. He will also install the 2 connector patch panels he brought out. Sasha will also install a gap spanner between MRM2 and the FGB. Once the gap spanner is installed, Sasha will translate down the FGB to Fyodor's worksite. Sasha will then route the MLM power cable number 1 down the FGB to MRM2, installing it in the cable fairleads previously installed. Fyodor will stay at the cable carrier and unwind the cable as Sasha routes it. In the digital display, you can see that the cable is flashing and is already installed. Once at MRM2, Sasha will attach cable number 1 to the connector patch panel previously installed, and any excess cable will be attached to an MRM2 handrail. Once the cable is attached to the patch panel, Fyodor will take the remaining cable from the cable carrier and attach it to the FGB handrail. Then Fyodor will translate down the FGB to MRM2, removing the slack from cable number 1. Once power cable number 1 is secure, Fyodor will route the MLM Ethernet cable down the FGB, attaching it into previously installed cable clamps. Sasha will stay at the Ethernet cable reel, unwinding the cable as Fyodor routes it. And again, the digital display shows the cable flashing and already routed. The Ethernet cable connector will temporarily be attached to an FGB handrail near the US and Russian interface. Once Fyodor is finished attaching the Ethernet connector to the FGB, Sasha will install the Ethernet cable into clamps at the end of the FGB and the MRM2 interface. Then Sasha will translate back to the universal cable carrier on the FGB and along the way taking the slack out of the Ethernet cable. Fyodor will now route MLM power cable number 2 along the FGB to the MRM2 as Sasha unwinds the cable from the carrier. Fyodor will install the cable into the cable fairleads along the FGB. And again, the digital display shows the cable flashing and already installed. Fyodor will attach the cable to the previously installed patch panel number 2, and any excess cable will be attached to MRM2's handrail. Once Fyodor is complete at the patch panel, Sasha will attach the remaining cable to an FGB handrail near the US and Russian interface. Then translate down the FGB, taking the slack out of the MLM power cable number 2. Fyodor will attach the cable number 2 to the cable clamps on the FGB and MRM2 interface. The two crew members will then translate back to DC1. The two crew members will ingress. This would conclude Russian EVA 34.